There was a time when energy was a scary word. One among a full load. Meltdown. Contamination. Liquidators. Iodine. Entire regions evacuated. Cities in brownout. Growing greenhouse effect. Where are we now? How do we make the world so much better? Right now, we're the largest producer of energy in the world. The energy of thorium. Today, Alvin Weinberg's dream, the man who devoted his entire life to a different nuclear power, has become reality. Thorium molten salt reactors supply the energy needs of nearly 70% of the planet. No melting down, no explosion, no waste. The green atom. A single thorium sphere the size of a ball can deliver one person's lifetime needs of electricity. Who would have thought? All the energy we ever needed, right under our feet. Thorium.
Still further in our future, another avenue of reactor research has led to the molten salt reactor experiment.
Every now and then, people keep coming back to the idea because it's such an attractive idea. Norway was where thorium was first discovered, so let's start there.
This small pit is the remains of the original site where thorium was first discovered in the 1820s. And the local vicar, who was a mineralogist of passion, he went out here to hunt ducks, but he hunted something else. He found a new mineral. And that new mineral, he didn't know. It was a brownish stuff. He sent it to the famous chemist in Sweden called Jakob Berzelius, now called the father of modern chemistry. And he was eager to look into this, and he became very enthusiastic because this was not only a new mineral, it was consisting of a new element. And he discovered that this was a very special kind of element, and he named it after the Norse god of thunder, Thor, and then it was named thorium.
Thorium and uranium was created in one or several supernovas over 6 billion years ago, when the solar system and the Earth was created. And this is why it is embedded in the Earth crust at various concentrations throughout our Earth.
So there are two potential nuclear fuels, uranium and thorium.
Thorium is a little bit lighter element than uranium. Uranium is element number 92, and thorium has two less protons, so it's element number 90. It's a so-called fertile material. It means that it can't fission directly. Uranium can fission directly. But thorium can capture neutrons in a reactor and become a type of uranium, and an isotope of uranium that can fission and release energy.
When a nucleus absorbs a neutron, the nucleus can split into fission fragments, and that is fission, or the nucleus can retain the neutron and through radioactive decays can become another element. And this is the case of the so-called fertile species. For example, when thorium-232 absorbs a neutron, it can become uranium-233. So uranium-233, like plutonium-239, are fissile species. They do not exist in nature, and they can be generated in a nuclear reactor as new fuels.
Il n'y a pas de différence vraiment notable entre le cycle thorium et le cycle uranium. Quand on les prend tout seul comme ça. Le cycle thorium prend tout son intérêt en combustible liquide parce qu'on a plein d'avantages qui apparaissent dans le combustible liquide.
Good. Thank you. If you want to put forward a genuine advantage of thorium, here's one.
There is more thorium in the world than uranium. It's around 4 times more thorium in the Earth's crust?
Well, one of the good things and the attractions about thorium is that it is widely distributed around the world. So no one country will be able, or a small group of countries will be able to monopolize the resource. With thorium, there's lots of thorium in Australia, India, China, Brazil, Indonesia, Turkey, South Africa. So there won't be an OPEC of thorium. It will be widely available for all, for everybody.
再生可能エネルギー、風力発電ですとか太陽光発電をしようとするときにはレアアースというある一つの材料が必要になります。これは中国でもアメリカでもヨーロッパでももちろん日本でも同じです。でこの風力発電などをするときにレアアースという材料が必要になりますが、このときに出てくる今はゴミになっているものがトリウムなんですね。そうするとウランの利用に太陽光発電、風力発電を加えて、これでトリウムはゴミとして出てくるとして終わるのが今の状態。
On a, par exemple, en France déjà 10 000 tonnes de thorium sur étagère accumulées, essentiellement du fait de l'exploitation des terres rares. Or, si on voulait produire toute l'électricité nucléaire qu'on produit actuellement en France avec du thorium, il nous faudrait 60 tonnes par an. Donc, on voit tout de suite qu'on a déjà pour plus d'un siècle de fonctionnement de disponible en France.Pour faire notre électricité nucléaire.
Ah. Yes, but there's once more a but.
Und das wird komplett von den Medien und von der Politik abgeblockt. Und das glaube ich nicht, dass das die Bevölkerung so denkt. Die Umfragen deuten sehr stark darauf hin, dass man sowas etwas interessant findet und daran forschen sollte.
We all encounter into various interest groups. First of all, for the traditional fossil energy industry.Yeah, especially as of today, because of the shale gas discovery in the U.S. And number two, in terms of the molten salt, which is a new nuclear technology, right? So it's also compete with, in the marketplace, with the water reactor, you know, industry. It's totally understandable.
Can a reactor be intrinsically safe and affordable?
Well, certainly some of the things that people say about the technology are correct. Light water reactors are vulnerable to meltdowns, that they have high pressure vessels, so that leads to some costs. There is a waste disposal issue where you have fissile materials in the waste, where you have plutonium in the waste.And so in a molten salt reactor, you are operating at atmospheric pressure. You're generating your fissile materials ideally on site. And so they feel that there are many safety issues in the design. You drain the reactor in an emergency. And so I think that there are some strong advantages, but they only see the advantages. So I don't say there are not advantages compared to the present technology.But the system of actually the thorium reactor that has been proposed has never really been properly tested.
La grosse difficulté de ces systèmes passifs, c'est justement ça. Que dans la mesure où personne n'a à intervenir sur eux, la seule garantie de leur bon fonctionnement, c'est qu'ils aient été testés et validés dans les vraies conditions réelles dans lesquelles ils seront utilisés. Évidemment, pour un réacteur qui est nouveau, ces conditions réelles sont difficiles.
Tout ça, ce sont des petits tests indépendants, pas forcément très chers, qu'il faut mettre en place. Et donc, dans les quelques années qui viennent, on a besoin de quelques millions d'euros, entre 3, 4, 10 millions d'euros. On peut déjà démontrer beaucoup de choses. On peut aller très loin avec ça.
That sounds like a lot of money. It is a lot of money. But in the economy that we're dealing with here, that's not much money at all. And Goldman Sachs, for example, had a...The company that was instrumental in screwing up the world's economy in 2008. In 2010, their bonuses were $16 billion. $16 billion with a B, which would have been enough to build at that time about 4 huge reactors that would produce clean energy for 60 years and employ hundreds and hundreds of people
paying it back, etc. So, you know, when we're talking about money and investment, think of what money really means.
Sometimes the market economy or market force not necessarily drive you into the right direction. So we have to have the leadership, the wisdom, and long-term vision, perception, to give the things like molten salt reactor technology development the support.
And then,
大家现在看到的这个回路正在进行升级改造，我们不停地对回路增加新的功能做新的实验。那么这个回路是我们现在至少拥有的五个熔岩实验回路中间的一个，我们这每一个回路都有它特殊的用途，去做某一类的实验，验证某一类的理论，这么多的回路在一起，它构成了一个系统，使我们能够比较系统地去研究熔岩堆，这是我们现在拥有的一个独特的优势。
66%
of our primary energy came from coal. So China is still a coal-dominant energy consumption country, with only less than 10% accounts for non-fossil energy.
中国发展土级熔岩堆，目的是为了解决中国的。There
was hundreds of scientists in the United States and around the world that have been lamenting the fact that, of what might have been. But now, fortunately, a lot of those folks are still with us.
Our pioneer today, they probably already 70, 80 years old. They are still alive. They are still very passionate about molten salt reactor in China, in this project, because they started in the first place 40 years ago.
There will be many enthusiastic younger nuclear engineers who will shape a better second nuclear era and who will be around to enjoy the fruits of their endeavors. My only regret is that, being too old, I will not be here to witness their success.
We have completed the